What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the 31 Days of Horror. I'm your host, Moon616, and thank you once again for stopping in, guys. Yes, the 31 Days of Horror Volume 6, Day 29, coming at you live. And yes, for today, we're going to take it back to 2005 with a film from South Korea. And it is part of the Tartan Asian Extreme line, and it is called Cello. Yes, people, this is another subtitled film. I believe this is actually the 13th different country I've covered so far during the 31 Days of Horror, which is pretty cool. I usually try to get at least a dozen different countries covered and, you know, try to cover, you know, from the 30s all the way to present films and stuff. That's kind of like the only kind of structure that I use with this 31 Days of Horror. People ask me all the time how I pick my films and stuff, and that's basically about it. Get one from each decade and try to cover a bunch of different countries and stuff. And yes, so for today, we're taking it to South Korea. This film is from 2005, and this is one right here that I'm not even sure still if I've seen it before. Now, I wanted to do something from the Asian Extreme line, and I was kind of going through the films, and I was like, well, I've seen all these ones and stuff, and I came across this, and it's funny because after even watching it, I'm not sure if I've seen it in the past, so it may or may not be a first time watch. I'm not too sure. Very odd. That usually does not happen to me, so just I don't know how to explain this away. But anyways, getting into synopsis. Basically, this one's about our main character, Mi Zhu. She is a cello teacher in a music school in the present day. Her past involves you know, quite a bit of a tragedy. She was like this cello prodigy, I would say. Basically, you know, she was competing with her best friend for, you know, this highest regards of celloism and stuff like that. Anyways, what happens is one day they were heading home and they get into a car accident and her best friend actually dies. So during the present day, she's been dealing with the death of her best friend forever. It's really affected her to the point where she actually doesn't even really play cello anymore. She just teaches it. And she kind of got a little bit disfigured on her arms and things like that from the accident stuff. But she mentally is just really dealing with the loss of her best friend. So basically, one day after class, this student comes up to her and basically confronts and threatens her about Mi Zhu basically failing her. And, you know, this girl wasn't able to get her, you know, a scholarship and stuff like that. She kind of touches her arm and she has like this crazy weird kind of vision shit. Ultimately, she's driving home one day or after this event and she almost gets into a car accident. She gets home, meets her family and stuff, and shit just goes fucking crazy from there, man. All this supernatural stuff starts happening. People start dying. And now she's got to figure out what the hell's going on. She's not sure if she's been cursed or if her dead friend is haunting her. She has no idea what's going on. And that is the mystery. So, So that's the synopsis. My thoughts on this one. Now, if you're familiar with like Asian ghost stories and stuff, you know that these movies are going to be more or less a slow burn type film. This one definitely falls into that category. Now, if you're not into slow burn ghost stories or supernatural type films, it probably won't be for you because it definitely plays right into that realm. You know, my thoughts on this film, though, I think this is actually a really well-made film. There's a lot of really good stuff going on here. Like, me personally, I'm a big fan of slow burn type films if the payoff is good. That's the whole thing with slow burn type ghost stories and these type of films, is that you can watch these movies and if the payoff sucks, it kind of ruins the whole movie, essentially. With this, you know, if you watch these movies and they have a good payoff, then it's kind of worth the whole fucking thing. This one right here has got a really good development to it, man. I really enjoy everything that's kind of happening and stuff. The one thing that really separates this film from a lot of ghost stories is the awesome music, because her being a cello teacher, right there, it allows, you know, them to use the strings from the cello as the score, and it's very, very haunting. Like, cello strings can be super, super, like, haunting sounding and stuff, and it really does work for this film. It creates this almost like nauseating dark atmosphere to the film, because you really have no idea what's happening throughout the film, because you don't know, like the main character, she has no idea what's really happening. So it really does add to this shit, man. And I think that's really cool, man. So basically, once she gets home, people start dying off in her house. She's got a husband, she's got two young daughters, and the husband's, I think, sister lives in the house, and also there's a housekeeper in here. So there's quite a bit of people that are involved in this house and stuff. And I gotta say, man, there's moments in this film that are pretty crazy, man. They kind of go, you know, a little bit extreme with a couple of the deaths. I'm not gonna say who dies and stuff, but I was like, damn, man, it gets pretty fucking crazy with a couple of the deaths. basically to who dies. That's what the crazy part is, and like how they die and shit, I thought was pretty nasty. But so that's pretty cool, man. It does get pretty bloody and gory at times, which is always a plus. It's 2005, so some of the visual effects are a little bit dated in this. Like there's a couple scenes with broken glass and a couple things that they had to CG, you know, effect wise for visual effects, a little dated and stuff. But for myself, it actually just kind of added to experience, because you're watching this film from 2005 and it feels very much like that time period. So the effects weren't really affecting me too much overall, you know, being like, oh, that looks terrible and stuff, because nothing's really that bad. It's just, you can tell it's a little bit dated and stuff. But I will say, you know, a lot of these type of ghost stories, supernatural films, usually have an abundance of terrible jump scares and things like that. This one really doesn't have a lot of that fucking bullshit in it, which is quite surprising, because again, from this era of filmmaking, there's a lot of films from this time period that totally just rely on the cheap jump scares and all that type of bullshit. This one doesn't, man. It relies on its slow moving narrative and, you know, the really daunting music and just the development within, you know, the dialogue too and stuff like that. There's a really great scare scene in this film involving one of her kids, and I was like, holy shit, that was actually really good. It actually kind of got me, and it doesn't usually happen very often. And going back to me seeing this film before, I don't think I've seen this film before, because I think I would have remembered that. But yeah, I was very impressed with the lack of like good scares in this film, or I mean the lack of like jump scares, and just the good scares in this film were definitely outnumbering the, you know, all the other bullshit that could have been there. So that was very much a plus, because ghost stories, man, sometimes you kind of go into them and you're like, okay, what am I going to get here? But this one plays itself pretty straightforward and stuff. Now, going into the third act, it goes pretty batshit insane in the third act. And then there's a moment of a reveal and you're like, oh my God, seriously? No. You know, you have that kind of moment, and then it redeems itself. And I was like, okay, fucking thank God it didn't go into that direction and stuff. So I was having kind of like one of those heart attack moments where I'm like, man, dude, the very end of this movie just totally shit on itself and shit the bed hardcore, but then it totally goes back and does it properly. Without giving anything away, of course. But it's a very good ride. I think the acting is pretty good in this film. I think they're pretty ballsy with some of the deaths in this film. And but again, with these supernatural ghost stories, these Asian ghost stories, there's always things after you're finished watching the movie, you're like, why the fuck did that happen in the movie? Like, it doesn't play into the end result. And you're like, what the fuck? It's just there to throw you off. It's like, it's a lot of like going back to, you know, Italian films and nightmare logic and things like that. I just kind of incorporate that nightmare logic into shit like this when I'm watching it. I'm like, you know what? That shit's just meant to throw you off. It's meant to get you thinking, stuff like that. It doesn't really play into the narrative in the final result, and which is kind of odd. But lo and behold, it's still a really entertaining film if you like slow burn films, which I really do. I love a great atmospheric film with a good score. This is what you get here. It doesn't really pull any punches. It kind of does it straightforward and, you know, twist it up in the end and stuff, but it's pretty easy to follow. So I'm going to come in at about a 7 out of 10 on this one. It's not the greatest ghost narrative I've ever heard of. I mean, this type of story has been done many times before, but I think they did it pretty good. And I'm really glad it didn't cheap out. It didn't get cheap with nasty jump scares and a whole pile of garbage that they could have done. So that's always a plus. And I love the music and I thought it was great. It was very haunting. So Cello, 7 out of 10. Very entertaining, slow burn supernatural ghost story. So, but yeah, guys, that's gonna do it for day 29. Check you guys tomorrow in day 30. We're almost at the end. You know, you can just feel the end coming. This month always goes by so fast. It's crazy, because, you know, this has to be the fastest moving month for me, because I'm so busy every single day, whether it's, you know, doing the 31 Days of Horror, doing the podcast, and just life in general. This whole month always seems like a huge blur to me. It's crazy. But anyways, guys, yeah, I'll be back tomorrow with day 30. I do know what I'm doing for the next 2 days, because I picked out a couple films. Might as well, right? So check you guys then. And as usual,